Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Hardeksha's Medical Science. Today we'll have a discussion on an interesting topic, that is menstrual cycle. We will understand the periods in just four easy steps. Female reproductive system. If you'll see the female reproductive system closely, it looks like this, which is majorly comprises of four organs. The lowest organ is named vagina, followed by, in the middle, there is a uterus. From the top of a uterus, two fallopian tubes are arising out, and end of the fallopian tubes, there are two ovaries associated with it. Come to the menstrual cycle. The cycle, which is generally of 28 days, that means this cycle repeats for a woman after every 28 days. Now, which are the women enters into the menstrual cycle? All the women with an age generally around 12 years enters into the menstrual cycle. This may vary in between 8 years to 16 years. And generally, the women ends with the menstrual cycle at the age of 51 years. Again, it varies from 48 years to 58 years. End of the menstrual cycle, the phase is known as a menopause. This menstrual cycle is easily understood in a four different phases or a four different steps. The first step is menstrual phase. The second phase is follicular phase. The third phase is ovulation phase. And the final phase is a luteal phase. Let's come to the first phase, that is menstrual phase. We also know this as periods. During this phase, the changes are observed in uterus. Within a uterus, there is a thin lining present named endometrium. During this phase, there is a shedding of endometrial lining. This lining starts shedding during this phase. Because of this, the inner layer of a uterus, that is the endometrium, become very thin. This phase generally lasts in between 3 days to 7 days with the average of a 5 days length. During the 5 days of length, the average blood loss is in between 40 ml to 50 ml. The second phase is the follicular phase. In this phase, the changes are observed within the ovary. Within an ovary, the multiple follicles are present. Out of the lakhs of follicles present within the ovary, every cycle, only 25 to 30 follicles in each ovary starts growing. Since the follicles are growing, the process is known as folliculogenesis, which generally lasts in between 6 days to 13 days. During the same follicular phase, the changes are also observed in an inner lining of a uterus, that is endometrium. This ovary starts secreting a hormone named estrogen. This estrogen goes and binds with the endometrial lining and starts making it thicker again. This is the same endometrial lining a woman has lost during the first phase, that is a menstrual phase. So, with the help of estrogen, the endometrial lining starts becoming thicker again. This process is named a proliferation. Again, it will last in between day 6 to day 13. Third phase is named ovulation phase. During the ovulation phase, the changes are observed again within the ovary. During a follicular phase, we have seen that there is a progress or there is a growth of nearly about 25 to 30 follicles in each ovary. What happened to all those 30 follicles which are growing? Most of them will die. Only one follicle will become a mature follicle or a graafian follicle. This one follicle, which is present in the ovary, starts releasing the egg in the fallopian tube. Since egg or ovum is released into the fallopian tube, this phase is named ovulation phase. If there is a sexual intercourse takes place during this period, a sperm from a male partner enters into the vagina and they will travel to the length up to the fallopian tube, where a sperm and an ovum combine together, which ultimately may result into the pregnancy. The one follicle which has released the egg, now named as corpus luteum, and based on its name, the fourth phase is named as the luteal phase. Within a luteal phase, the changes are again observed both at the ovarian level as well as at the endometrial level. The corpus luteum, which was formed in phase 3, that is ovulation, now starts releasing hormone named progesterone. This progesterone goes and binds with the endometrium, which already has made during the follicular phase. This progesterone makes the endometrium more nutrient by providing a blood vessels. So progesterone, by providing more blood to the endometrium, prepare it for the pregnancy. This phase generally lasts in between 15 days to 28 days. Suppose there is no pregnancy. If pregnancy takes place, the menstrual cycle stops for throughout the period of pregnancy. But if there is no pregnancy, what happens? This corpus luteum, which was secreting the progesterone which was responsible for providing the blood to the endometrium, in the absence of pregnancy, this corpus luteum collapses on 28th day. Once the corpus luteum collapses, that means progesterone supply to the endometrium is stopped. That means now your endometrium does not have sufficient amount of blood, does not have sufficient amount of nutrients. In the absence of nutrients, the entire endometrium starts collapsing again. So again, the endometrium collapses and a bleeding starts again. Woman enters into the phase 1 of a bleeding or a periods. This phase again will continue for next 3 to 5 days, again followed by the follicular phase. Follicular phase is followed by ovulation, and ovulation is again followed by luteal phase. Thanks for watching. Please do like, subscribe and share for more videos. Thank you.